A very happy and cheerful morning to all my dear students. I hope you all are fine at home and taking care of your health. So we're back with our general knowledge class. And today we are going to study about traditional outfits of different countries of the world. Okay, so we are going to study about the traditional outfits, that is what they wear. Okay, see, we know about India. The traditional outfit is sari, but we don't know about some other places across the world, so that we are going to study in this chapter. Okay, so let's start with it.
Traditional outfits, India, sari.
So the first one is of India. Okay, so we know that traditional outfit of India is sari. It comes in beautiful colors, right? So it is a traditional outfit of the women. Now let's see of other countries.
Spain.
Okay, the second one is Europe. The traditional outfit of the women of Europe is dirndi. Okay, see in your textbook, it is there at page number 19. The second one is of Europe. So the traditional outfit is dirndi. See, this is how it looks like. Okay, moving on to the next.
Spain, Paris. Vietnam.
Third one is of Spain, that is polaris. Okay, that is given over here. The third one, the spelling is polaris. So you see the gown, okay, it's a beautiful gown and there is polka dots all over. So this is known as polaris.
Vietnam, Ao Dai.
Okay, so of Vietnam, what is it? Ao Dai. A-O-O Ao and Dai. D-A-I. Ao Dai. You see the traditional outfit? They wear a hat like this. Okay, and it is this dress. Okay, so this is the dress that is of Vietnam. So in the textbook at fourth position, you have to write below Vietnam, it is a Ao Dai. Okay, it is a long dress. It is like a tunic dress, okay, worn over the trousers. See, they wear trousers and they wear this tunic dress. Next.
Japan, kimono.
Yes, so the next one is of Japan. So I'm sure many of you watch cartoons, different cartoons. Okay, so there are many Japanese cartoons as well. So in that, they show the outfits of the girls, that is kimono. Okay, it's a beautiful outfit as you see. There are different patterns, different varieties you will see. Okay, so this is the outfit of Japan. It is at fifth number, Japan. What is it? Kimono. K-I-M-O-N-O. Kimono.
China. Joseon.
Okay, and the last one is of China, that is Cheongsam. What is the name? Cheongsam. So what is the spelling of Cheongsam? C-H-E-O-N-G, Cheong, S-A-N, Cheongsam. Okay, so it is given the sixth image, that is of China. The traditional outfit of women in China is Cheongsam. Okay, so you have to write accordingly in your textbook. See? Okay, so these are the traditional outfits. Okay, so these were the different outfits of different countries, places of the world, that is of women. Now it's time for a quiz.
Quiz time. Take the correct answers.
Okay, now the first one is of Malaysia. Can you see the women? Okay. So what is this outfit known as? Baju kurung. And the second one is of Hawaii. You see the girl over here? So the traditional outfit of Hawaii is known as Momo. Okay, so you have to answer this. Option A and option B. Now know the fact?
Know the fact. Sari is one of the oldest garments of the world.
Yes, isn't it? See, our traditional culture of India, it shows that sari is the oldest garment of the world. So not only of India, but in the world, it is very well recognized. And today it is so popular that you'll find it in many places, in many foreign countries as well. Okay, so sari is one of the oldest garments of the world. Real life?
Real life. Ask your mother or grandmother to show you a traditional outfit of India. Learn the name and share it in class.
Yes, so we can try to do this. See, in many different castes and cultures, they wear different outfits. That is, in saris also there are different varieties. Okay, in south, in east, different varieties are there. So you ask your mother, not only in saris, if there are suit also, if there are different outfits, you ask the traditional outfits of your culture and we'll discuss about it. Okay, so this is it for now. In this class, we studied about the traditional outfits and the world. In the next class, we will learn something new. So till that, God bless you all. Goodbye.